film, you guys. Say hi, Bernie. And Hazel. Hi, guys. Welcome or welcome back. It's Mary Elizabeth here. I feel like I have a really good transformation on my hands. I'm a huge fan of paint. I partnered with Sherwin-Williams on this video, and I'm really excited about it. I would like to say, first of all, that paint is the fastest, most inexpensive, and most dramatic way to change a space real quick. I wound up going with a color called Inkwell. It's a dark, dark, dark navy. I would almost say it maybe has a tinge of like, I don't know, sometimes it looks black, sometimes it looks navy. It's almost charcoal-y. I love this color. I love this color. And I love that it just kind of grabs different tones at different times. The one thing I knew walking into this space was that I wanted the fireplace to be the focal point, and it just wasn't. There's a lot of positives about the space, and that's what I try and do. I look at the pros and the cons of any space and then figure out what I want to do with it. So the pros of this space is that it's a big open space. It's awesome. A big, huge rectangle, no weird like kind of corners or anything, and very open. So that is a huge plus. Now the cons are that it tends to be dark in here. You get light really from one source, and when the light goes down or it moves down later in the afternoon, it's dark in here. An awkward point of this room is that the fireplace isn't really symmetrical, and you walk in through the entry, and so you need an entrance. So it's like, are you walking in front of the fireplace, or where can you kind of situate? I swear to you, if you have paint and you decorate, you can almost make anything look cute, even if it has its imperfections, has like a little bit of issues. So originally I thought to myself, I want to make this symmetrical. I'm going to do the Inkwell across on this wall through the entry, and maybe it will give, and maybe I'll even cover the molding. And so it will be like solid color here and kind of give a focal point that way. Then as I started painting, I basically realized, oh my gosh, I like this dark so much, I want it everywhere.
Okay, so I'm back in the rain, 15 minutes to closing, getting another can of Inkwell.
I'm kind of the school of thought, like if you like it, just go for it. I have to say, zero, zero regrets about painting it all Inkwell. It's amazing. Like,
oh, Hazel.
It's exactly, exactly what this space needed. I'm actually a big fan of that. I think like our instinct is to want to brighten up kind of a dark room. And I think you just kind of have to go with it and make it cozy. So I pulled the sofa off the wall. We've always been a sofa on the wall. Just to kind of put it in and make it a little bit more conversational and make it sort of about the fireplace. And my rug kind of anchored all of it. So then it's like, what do I do with the wall? Where do I position the TV? And I kind of like a TV not as a focal point of a room. And it works really well with dark paint because the TV kind of recesses into the paint a little bit and I just ignore it. I've got to have my little bar entertaining kind of spot that kind of can move around, and this whole space kind of becomes a place that you can sit there, sit here, have a drink, move around, and it feels very like flowy, have the fireplace going. And I added a little disco ball next to the fireplace too, just to add a little bit of sparkle. I think it's kind of fun and it sort of breaks it up. So I think it's a really good idea in design to mix together like feminine shapes, which are like circles, and masculine shapes, which are really like chunky and square. And I feel like that's the good dynamic. So I had a lot of square going on up here with the fireplace. So I just thought a little round would soften it a little bit. The same thing for my little side tables that I have in front of the sofa. is they're a pair. I got them at the thrift store and fell in love with them. They're mid-century. And I saved the glass inlay, but I had this marble top that I saved from an old coffee table for forever ago. I put it on a, sometimes I put it on a dining table and I've just had it for a really long time. I put it on here and I'm loving that they like match, but don't match. And it sort of gives this like ability for movement and versatility and softness that I really like. I also really like doing the pouf because it gives another option to sit and also be cozy and sit by the fire, but not have a chair that sort of obstructs you and obstructs the view from walking in. So I tried to kind of like soften it, add a little bit of seating without really blocking anything off. And now there's sort of an entrance to entry, come in here, go around. So we have the entry table, you can drop your keys in there, drop the mail, whatever, walk in, sit down here if you want to sit on the bench, but the bench also kind of becomes part of the living room. So it just kind of gives a lot of moments for different areas. And then I need a little desk area, so my little secretary, which doubles for storage and is the perfect little thing. Another element that I think really modernized the space and made a huge, huge, huge difference was getting rid of the draperies. I mean, as soon as I saw them, I was like, it's just a lot. And there was just so much. So it's like a dark space. You have these heavy curtains. It's painted tan, which I actually think is a really pretty color, but then all the furniture is also brown. And then it's also kind of tonal with the fireplace. So the fireplace didn't stick out. So it was just time for a little bit of a refresh. Some of you might notice some of the pieces from my room wound up out here. Well, my room has been rearranged already, and I just kind of share. It's like whatever works there, and it kind of becomes very fluid. So I'm gonna do a room tour soon, and I'll show you how I did a different layout that I feel more comfortable with that isn't going to have the sun on my bed all the time. So I'm gonna link to the bedroom video that I did before as well in case you wanna see it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I think it's a pretty dramatic transformation. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and shout out to Sherwin-Williams for being awesome and having the paint of my dreams and making my living room come true. I will see you guys next time. Bye.